Why is the United States not a member of the ICC? The answer to this question is complex and has many parts. No single reason can be given, but three presidencies, concern for American citizens, and issues of ratification have kept the United States from joining the court. Historical relationship with the ICC. The relationship of the United States and the ICC began during the time of President Clinton. Clinton signed the Rome Statute and was open to the idea of the court, but did note some concerns and had reservations about ratifying the Rome Statute. When President Bush began his presidency, he took an entirely different approach to the ICC. He was fundamentally against the court because he feared for the protection of American soldiers. At the time, the United States was engaged in the Iraq War, and President Bush was concerned that American soldiers performing their military duties would be held liable before the ICC. To prevent this from happening, President Bush unsigned the Rome Statute and actively worked against the court through bilateral agreements. Bilateral agreements were between the United States and other nations, where both parties agreed to the protection of American citizens from prosecution by the ICC. The United States made bilateral immunity agreements with over 100 countries. Interestingly, though, the United States is one of the five permanent members of the United Nations Security Council. This means that they have the power to defer any case at the ICC, as is guaranteed in the Rome Statute. Essentially, the United States has the authority to put a halt to any case brought against it. When President Obama took office, the United States' relationship with the ICC changed once again. President Obama re-signed the Rome Statute and began sending American delegations to conferences of the ICC. Although not a member, the United States is certainly taking a more active approach to working with the court. Challenges to joining the court. Besides the political approval of America's president, there are also issues of complementarity challenging the United States from joining the court. As already stated, the United States has signed, unsigned, and re-signed the Rome Statute. But the signature is essentially nothing more than a pledge of support. Ratification is where real commitment occurs. When the Rome Statute is ratified, nations agree to achieve complementarity in the national laws, meaning they will make their national laws support the mission of the ICC. In order for ratification by the United States to occur, though, the United States Senate would need to approve the Rome Statute by a two-thirds majority. This can be very challenging, especially in today's political climate.